Well, it seems to me, if you're saying that these particles are in fact spherical standing waves with a particle effect at their wave centre, that that's a very obvious explanation of the particle wave duality. Why isn't it obvious to everyone, and hasn't been obvious for the last 100 years, that this is an obvious solution to describing matter in space?
I think people are just creatures of habit. People get in the habit. It's hard to change.
I just had a habit of thinking of particles.
Exactly.
Particles. What did Einstein think matter was in his general relativity?
Einstein is one of the most misunderstood people in the world. Everybody imagines Einstein as declaring there are four dimensions and time goes backwards and frontwards and nothing is the way you really see it. But no, he thought carefully and logically and almost came to all the right conclusions about particles. He said they had to be expended. He realized that they have to interact with each other. You can't just say, it happens, nature made it that way. No, he realized that they had to be spherical, have the symmetry, because there's no other symmetry that's possible. We live in a 3D universe.
So what did he imagine instead of the particle? What did he think matter was?
Unfortunately, he lived in the aftermath of a famous man called Maxwell. Maxwell was the man who wrote down equations for radio waves before there were radio waves, and lo and behold, another guy named Hertz came along and discovered radio waves. Everybody said, gee, that's great. Maxwell must be right.
And what did Maxwell use? What was he assuming existed to discover?
He assumed there are electric fields and magnetic fields, and these fields somehow go out from particles, and they exist there, out around every particle, sort of like a halo of light. And when another particle gets into the field of another particle, they interact. One, they pull together or pull apart. And but the only problem is that these fields don't respond to experiments that way. Apparently there are no electric and magnetic fields. They're just a mathematical help. Very useful. They give you the right engineering answers, but the fields aren't real.
So Einstein assumed that matter was a spatially extended field.
Right.